Imagine a world where planes wouldn't be reusable, where instead of just refueling the plane to make a round trip, you'll need a new plane to do that. Given that the price of a new Boeing 737 is $100 million, you'll have to be a billionaire to afford to fly. Thankfully, in our world, planes are reusable, and we only pay for fuel, pilot salaries, and some maintenance. But this is not how things work in the rocket industry. After each launch, used rockets simply fall into the ocean or on the ground and essentially become scrap metal. And oh boy, how expensive it is. For example, in the 1970s, the launch price of the Saturn V rocket was over $1 billion, adjusted for inflation. You heard me right. And this is just the launch, just the rocket. The price of a payload is not included. Yes, in all fairness, rocket launches got cheaper over time. For example, in 2010, the launch price of the Proton rocket was $140 million. But that's still a lot, and it shouldn't be this way. Rockets should work the same way as planes, meaning that you should only pay for fuel. Space should become more accessible. But for the most history of the spaceflight, it seemed that nobody was interested in that. Except for one guy, who decided to invest most of his money to build the first reusable rocket in history. Of course, I'm talking about Elon Musk, SpaceX, and their Falcon 9 rocket. But just to be clear, this video is not about Musk or about SpaceX. This is an engineering channel. This video is about the Falcon 9 rocket, and particularly about the specific design features that make it reusable. So how does the Falcon 9 rocket work? In the beginning, it looks and acts like any other rocket. Its engines ignite, it goes into orbit, then the second stage separates and carries the payload to the necessary altitude. But after the second stage separation, happens something interesting. If a regular non-reusable rocket, or particularly its first stage, will simply drop to Earth, Falcon 9 does something else. It performs a flip maneuver. Like, the booster flips in space. And then it lands on Earth. And then it can be reused again. And I'm getting a little ahead of myself, but the current reusability record is 19 times. SpaceX reused the first stage 19 times. That's huge. But how are they doing that? What makes the rocket reusable? To perform a flip maneuver, the first step, the booster needs something that will generate thrust. For this, SpaceX uses coal gas thrusters. This is a type of rocket engine that uses the expansion of pressurized gas to generate thrust. What's interesting is that compared to traditional engines, there is no combustion of fuel in coal gas thrusters. This is why they are considered one of the simplest types of rocket engines, because they only consist of a fuel tank, a regulating valve, a propellant nozzle, and some plumbing. Coal gas thrusters are the simplest, cheapest, and most reliable propulsion systems available for orbital maneuvering. After the flip maneuver, the first stage starts re-entry. This step is challenging because there are high risks of overheating as the booster goes through the thickest part of the atmosphere. To avoid heat damage, engines reignite to perform an entry burn. It severely slows down the stage and also creates a bubble of gas which shields it from extreme temperatures. Additionally, there are heat shields at the base of the first stage, which protect the engines and the plumbing. When the booster re-enters, it needs to be stabilized. For this purpose, it features titanium grid fins. Grid fins were invented in the USSR in the 1950s, and since the 1970s, they used them on their ballistic missiles. SpaceX tested them in 2014, and since then, they have continued to use them to this day. They were originally made of aluminum, but proved to be unreliable, so they switched to using titanium. After the booster has passed through the thickest part of the atmosphere, it briefly stops its engines. Once it gets close to the ground, it reignites the engines for the final time to perform a landing burn. They slow down the booster so that it can safely land. When it's really close, it deploys its legs and the Falcon has landed. After that, the booster gets transported back to SpaceX, gets some refurbishment, and can be used again. As Elon said, they save about $25 to $29 million each time they fly a pre-flown Falcon 9 booster. The boosters cost them $30 million to build, and it only costs $250,000 to refurb them for reuse. Today, Falcon 9 is one of the cheapest rockets on the market. It has a price of $2,000 per kilogram of payload. For comparison, the Proton rocket has a price of $4,000 per kilogram. The Ariane 5G costs $9,000, and the Electron costs $19,000. But Elon believes they can lower the price even further to just $10 per kilogram with their Starship. We'll see how it goes. Thank you for watching. See you soon.